Hello people, I am Prithvi. In this video, I shall give an explanation for how the principal planes are related to the eigenvectors of the stress tensor in an intuitive way. If you don't understand what a tensor is, just understand it as a matrix for now. I shall first talk about the eigenvalues and vectors, and then I shall go about the connection between the eigenvector and the principal planes. To understand this video better, you need a background of state of stress, principal stresses, and Mohr circle. If you'd like to review these concepts, check the link at the description section. Let me explain the eigenvalues and vectors for you now. Let's first analyze the product of a matrix A and a vector X. Let me illustrate this with a simple example. I have taken A as 2 by 2 matrix as shown, and we shall consider two different cases for x. In case 1, x is taken as 1, 1, and note that Ax will also be a vector. I have plotted them in a graph for easy understanding and interpretation. Now, what is this graph telling you? Do you see that the resultant vector has been scaled and rotated as compared to x? So, you multiplied a matrix and a vector and you got the resultant to be scaled and rotated. Let's now see what case 2 has to tell us. X is taken as 1, 2 here, and do you see the difference? The resultant is scaled but not at all rotated. A vector that undergoes pure scaling without any rotation is known as the eigenvector corresponding to that matrix, and the scaling factor is known as the eigenvalue, and here it will be 5, which means that the resultant is 5 times that of the x. And a quick question for you, does this definition hold good for a complex case? Just think about it. Let me dig this further. We know that Ax equal to 5, 10 for this case. Let me take 5 out of this equation. So we get something like this. And we know this corresponds to x. Let me replace that by x, and we get finally Ax equal to 5x, and we know phi is a scalar. Let me generalize it by putting a lambda here. And do you recognize this? This is the famous eigenvalue equation that you see in most of the textbooks. Remember these two important keywords, scaling and no rotation. Now, let's understand rotation in context of solid mechanics. Consider two perpendicular line elements in an unloaded structure as shown. If we load the structure in torsion, we'll find out that these lines would have rotated and the angle between them will no longer be 90 degrees. The deformation that led to this change in 90 degree angle is known as shear deformation or simply shear. Not only torsion, other loading states can also cause this. As this involves some rotation here, we can also term this as relative rotation. I called it relative because there could be a case wherein there is a rotation but still the angle between them remains 90 degrees, like the rigid body rotation where both the lines rotate by the same amount preserving the 90 degree angle. And rigid body rotation has nothing to do with shear. You can also understand shear as anything that causes a shape change. And now just remember this for the forthcoming slides. Let me quickly review the principal planes. There is one particular coordinate system about which there will be zero shear stresses, and the corresponding planes are called the principal planes. Let's understand this using the same example. If you obtain the stress state at this point, you will have the state of pure shear with respect to the coordinate system shown. With this, we can draw the Mohr circle and obtain the principal plane positions, which happen to be these two points. These correspond to a coordinate system oriented at 45 degree, and note that there are no shear stresses. To summarize, this is that one coordinate system, and these two are the principal planes defined by the two basis vectors of the coordinate system. Principal plane A dash is defined by the basis vector X dash, and B dash is defined by Y dash. We have seen that two perpendicular lines taken like this undergo shear deformation. But what if you take two perpendicular line elements corresponding to the coordinate system X dash, Y dash like this? We know that with respect to X dash, Y dash, there is no shear, and hence there will be no relative rotation. And the only possibility is that they can stretch without rotation like this. If you consider each of these vectors, they have scaled without rotation, and by definition, each of them is an eigenvector. And we have also seen that they define principal planes, and that's how eigenvectors corresponds to principal planes. Also, the eigenvalues correspond to the principal stresses, but it's a bit tricky to explain it intuitively. Try it yourself and let me know if you have any simple explanations. To summarize, if you know the stress state at a point corresponding to the loading state, it could be expressed in a matrix form like this. First row corresponds to the stress components at the x phase, second row has components at the y phase. Now, if you find the eigenvalues of this matrix, you will obtain the principal stresses, and the eigenvectors of the matrix will give you the principal planes. If you are interested, go through these additional details. With that, thank you very much for listening. And if you have questions, reach me via the comment section.